Hello everyone, welcome to Skills Will Training YouTube channel. Myself Mohammed Zubair, and this channel is all about showing you how to become a highly paid IT pro really fast. So the topic of today's video is Genome 41 First Thoughts and Review. So without any further ado, let's get started. The Genome Project released the Genome 41 desktop environment as the latest and most significant update to this popular graphical interface for Linux distributions. They have added some new features and have improved some processes to improve the system performance. You can find the Genome 41 desktop environment in the latest editions of Ubuntu, Fedora, and OpenSUSE. I'm using it in OpenSUSE. The first prominent feature is the power mode. If you click on the top right corner of your screen, here we have some options. First one is balance, and then we have power saver. These are some power modes. I'll go to my power setting, which is this one. So here we have two options in terms of power mode. You can select either one of these. And after that, we have power saving options, which are related to these two options. You can customize these two as per your liking. So that was the first significant update that got added in Genome 41. The other prominent feature in this version is the addition of multitasking section in the settings, which is right here. So I will just click on this one. First one is the hot corner. It will show you the activities overview if you hover towards the left corner of your screen. Then we have active screen edges. Well, if you drag application towards the left or right corner of your screen, it will adjust your application accordingly. So I'm going to drag it towards the left side of my screen and it will adjust it accordingly. So here it will adjust it on the whole screen, but here it will adjust it on the half of my screen. So this is how active screen edges work. Then we have workspaces. First option is dynamic workspaces, then we have fixed number of workspaces. If you go with dynamic workspaces, you can have as many workspaces as you want. But if you go with fixed number of workspaces, you will only be able to use fixed number of workspaces, which are 4 by default. So here you can increase those numbers or you can decrease as well. After that, we have multi-monitor, and then we have workspaces on all displays. This is related to your viewing of your activities. And to do so, just press your super key and it will show you all the activities. After that, we have application switching. Basically, the first option says include applications from all workspaces. It means if you have different applications open in different workspaces, and if you press Alt plus Tab key, it will allow you to shift through all the applications no matter in which workspace they are open. But if you go with the second option that says include applications from the current workspace only, it will only allow you to shift through the applications which are present in the current workspace. So that was all about the multitasking. Genome 41 has brought a new mobile network section. Again, I will open my settings. So I will just search here mobile, and here it is. It says mobile network. Well, this allows you to configure the mobile network connection and to work with 2G, 3G, 4G, and GSM LTE modems. But new mobile network settings will only be shown when a supported modem is available. You can set the network type, you can select whether the mobile data should be used or not, and you can also set if the data should be used while roaming or not. They have also added the support for using multiple SIMs and modems. And not only that, you can easily switch between the networks as per your need and choice. Genome 41 also ships with updated apps. For example, the new connection app offers user a modern and easy to use remote desktop client that supports both VNC and RDP connection. So I will just search for connections in my OpenSUSE, and here it is. So you can use this application for remote connections. The other update that we have in Genome 41 is they have updated the music app. They have redesigned the UI for this application. So I will press my super key. So this is our music app, and they have revamped it in terms of user interface completely. And after that, they have revamped the Genome Store app and updated the categories for browsing and exploring apps. So I will just open the software center of my OpenSUSE. So I will just search for software here. Here it is. I will just open it. Now we have the redesigned details page with more extensive screenshots and information tiles. So let me click on any one of these applications. Let's go with the Steam. Here we have more detail and more larger screenshot, and we have more detailed tiles of information, reviews, and many other things. Along with these things, they have upgraded the software app with more attractive layouts in the installed update views. So here we have different sections, as we know. This one is explore, then we have installed, and the last one is update. So they have revamped it completely. Other than that, they also have redesigned the section, or you can say these categories of different applications and softwares. Genome 41 has supported creating encrypted .zip archives in the file manager. And this change is among many other prominent changes. So I will just open my file manager and then I'll show you. This is my files manager, or you can also say it file explorer. Here, if I right click on this one, I can compress it. In earlier version, this feature was available, but now they have encrypted it. So they have included this functionality in Genome 41. Apart from these prominent features and functionalities, some of the performance improvements and bug fixes have made Genome 41 perform faster, reliable, stable, and flexible. Genome introduced the initial support for different applications to request the particular power mode. For example, let's say you are using some power-hungry application, or you are using some games that require some high power and some high resources. Those applications and games will be able to ask for the power themselves. It means they will have the needed power on their own. And Genome 41 also includes significant improvements for developers, and now we have 38 languages available for developers. So that was all about all the new things, improvements in the Genome 41, and we are done for the video. Please leave a like, subscribe, and press the bell icon. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care.